Hey everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another quick tutorial for you. And this time I'm talking about the new Microsoft Edge browser. Now, since Internet Explorer, everyone was so used to that, the blue E with the golden arch around it. Then we had the blue E without any golden arch, just kind of has a little indent in it. And then we've got now this new logo for the new Microsoft Edge. It's still the same name, but it's a newer version of it. So I want to show you a couple differences here with that and how we can get this installed if it didn't go in automatically. It should, for a lot of people I've found, it went in automatically. It just went in through an update, but others it hasn't done it. And if you're interested in getting it, I'm going to show you how. So one of the difference first is I've got the old one up here still. So the menu doesn't look very different when you hit the three dots in the top right corner. The menu we have here versus the new menu on the new Edge browser, it pretty much looks the same. But when you get into the settings on the old browser here, you'd have to scroll down on this little narrow area and choosing between a few different options here and scrolling down between each one. Now on the new browser, it opens it up kind of like in Firefox, where it opens taking over the entire screen. So I'm going to show you more interactive with that once we get it installed, but I wanted to go through the installation from the beginning. So if you're in the Edge browser, you want to get to this website, which you can go to by clicking the menu and going to help and feedback and then help. And it takes you to this web page, which I was already on, so I'm going to close the extra one here. And there's a short little video here that shows you a couple of things. And here you've got the legacy version of Edge, and then you've got the new version. So we just go to get it here. And you got this fancy looking website that tells you a little bit more, where they're claiming that it's got better performance, more privacy controls, other productivity tools. And there's another short little video on that, and they're claiming that they're upfront about the privacy options now. So it does tell you a few things in here with several more links to download it in case you missed the first download link, which is right at the top. So here we've got the fine print that nobody really ever reads. I've only known a couple of people that actually read the fine print, but you need to accept this agreement to download, and it tells you it will begin shortly. And because we're using Edge to download it, you can go to here, it tells you to run it or save it. Now it's a fairly small file, so I'll just run it. Otherwise, for larger installations, I would say to save it first, just in case something goes sideways. Now if you're waiting for something to happen, you gotta look down at the bottom of your screen. There's an alert flashing, and when you click that, you get this option here to say yes. A lot of people miss that, and they're waiting for something to happen. Meanwhile, it's flashing down there trying to get your attention to say, click on me. So now it's going through the process of downloading the full installation package, because all we downloaded so far was the downloader file. So now it's downloading the full thing, and it's gonna do the rest of it for us. So it says here we need to close the current version. So we'll do that. Yes, we'll close all the tabs. I don't have anything open. And now it's going to continue with doing the upgrade. Okay, so that only took a minute to install. And on my computer, which is pretty quick with a solid state drive, and it's telling us that it's doing a few things still. So there's no buttons to click on until now. We're seeing our welcome message, and there's our conversion from the old blue E to the newer version. So we'll go and hit get started, and it walks you through a little wizard at the beginning here. You can always change these options later, so it doesn't matter. If you want to just X out of here and get started on it, you can. But you can take some time if you want here. It shows you the theme when you're setting up a new page tab. If you want an inspirational look, which is what we have currently, or an informational look, which you can see in the background even, as well as the preview here, that is changed it so the search is at the top. You got some favorites along the top, and then you've got news articles underneath that, along with the weather. And then there's a focus look, which is very plain, clean, which is great for business when you want to stay focused and not be distracted by news or any fancy looking backgrounds that you might find yourself staring at for a long time. It's also got the option to use Microsoft's Bing search for your address bar and to see the new tab on startup. I personally find that Google works a whole lot better for searches than Bing, because when I'm looking for stuff, I've tried it with Bing and I don't find what I'm looking for at the top. But when I use Google, what I'm expecting to find at the top is at the top. So we hit confirm to jump to the next option here, and we're having the option to synchronize across all your devices. And I don't really have any need for that as far as the browser goes, like for your favorites, passwords, and all that. Just don't really want to have that kind of information stored in the cloud. So for privacy issues, if you want to have something more private, then you don't want to turn that on, and by default this is turned off. Otherwise you just hit this little button here and it'll turn it on, but I'm gonna click that and say no and confirm. And on the next screen here, there is another option to improve personalization of advertising, search, news, and other Microsoft services by allowing Microsoft to use your browsing history from this account. So they're asking if they can have your permission to basically spy on what you do online so that they can provide you with better advertising, because you will get advertisements and you can't really get away from that too much. There are ways around it, and I'm sure there'll be lots of comments, people posting what is the latest and greatest, but there's a lot of features built into a couple of these different web browsers now that will allow you to block a lot of advertising. So this is an option again that you can turn it on if you want to. I'm not going to turn that on, so I'm going to hit confirm, and now we've got our new browser. Now, for some reason, it's just refreshing itself after doing that, and now it's giving us a welcome message. So there's some quick tips here, how to find your favorites, installing extensions, and using the collections. I'm going to X out of there. It's also got a reminder pop-up over here that it's installed extensions automatically here for me for the new Edge add-ons, and that was the Avast Online Security that I had on the previous one, so they've just done that for me and moved that over, so that's great. So I'll just close that. So this is just a website. Again, it's giving you more information that you can scroll through and learn about this. Now, I had a toolbar that was on here, and it seems to have taken it off, so we want to be able to put that back on. So if we go into our menu here, we're going to be able to see the options as I had in the picture. I have the favorites. I want to go to show favorites bar, and then I have the option of always showing them, never, or only on new tabs. Well, I want to always have my favorites bar because I find that very helpful to be able to work with. Looking at the menu options, besides going through your websites, there's nothing different. You just go to your websites like you've always been doing. Now, the options through here, you've got some standard things as you had before, which is all the same. Going into settings is where we're going to see a huge difference here. We've got it coming up as a full screen like we had before. So you can see here, one of the options that we had when we first set it up was about synchronizing your data, and it's set to not sync. So I don't want that on, so I'm not going to go and turn on sync. There are options to manage your account, and that's the Microsoft account. Depending if you're signed into Windows with a Microsoft account, it'll pick that up automatically for you, which is somewhat convenient. But your syncing is a completely separate thing. If you go into sync, then you can turn on or off sync, and then hitting the arrow goes back. So this is kind of similar to what you had before. Now, on the previous version, we just had three options, and there was a privacy options and advanced settings, but they really break things down here and give you more of a full screen to work with. So under privacy and services, this is probably one of the first things you want to look at, and you can choose from basic if you are having things block you that you don't want to have blocked. Then maybe stick with basic, but if you want to try and make this as tight as possible, then you can go with the strict option here. And as it tells you, it blocks the majority of trackers from all websites, and content and ads will likely have minimal personalization. Because they're blocking it, they can't see anything to be able to determine what's the best ad to show you. But there's some problems that you may experience, such as some of the websites might not work properly. And if you do need to have some kind of tracking on in order to use certain websites, because they're blocked, those sites may not work. So the balance usually will work for most people in that case. So that seems to be the default here, and you can probably stick with that safely. But feel free to experiment and crank it up to strict and see how that works for you. It's easy enough to just switch it back by simply clicking on it and going from strict to balanced. And that changes some of the other options here, which you can also go down and customize and drill down into each one. So without making this into a very long video, there's a lot of options here, like clearing the browser data. You can go and clear it now, or choose how it clears, like every time you close the browser. So you can click choose, and within the last hour or all time, turn everything on and clear it. And then that will wipe out all the history, and it's good for performance as well as for your security and privacy. Which privacy is the next option down here. You've got other options as well. The appearance is something else. You can go in here to customize if you want the dark theme, which is what I like and I have on currently. And even though I don't really use this web browser, it's something that I was experimenting with a little bit. Having your favorites bar show always here. That's something that we already went to from another location, and some of the other options are here. On startup, you can choose if you want the new tab page to open or continue where you left off, or you can set a specific page or specific multiple pages to open every time you turn it on. So when you open up the web browser, if you want to go to Google, then just go to add a new page and type in google.com. If you've got other pages in here currently, you can hit the three dots there and delete what's in there. The new tab page is different. That's when you click the little plus sign up here at the top, so you can have multiple tabs open at once. You can change how the new tab page appears. So when you go into customize, then you've got the options here for what we had initially, and you can access that when you're on the main page here. is the little gear. You've got the focused look, so it's less distracting. You've got the inspirational look we had, or the informational, which gives you a lot of news, which is really distracting. Or you can go into customize and start setting some of these other options individually. I kind of like this look. You've got a whole host of options here for site permissions, and a lot of this is old, it's nothing new, but a couple of things, maybe JavaScript, if you're having issues and it's not allowing you, you might need to go into here, and then you can control your permissions. And that was JavaScript. Adobe Flash is another one. You don't necessarily have to install Adobe Flash Player. You just need to go in here and allow the permissions. And there is something else that was here on the other browsers I saw. And I think this is under notifications. And you'll see that something might have gotten in here to allow that you don't want, and then you start getting pop-ups for that. So you would have to go under site permissions and notifications and delete those that were allowed that you don't recognize. You can set this as your default browser if you want to, and you can manage your downloads. Family safety can be controlled from here, which is kind of convenient if you've got a family that you're using this with. You can change the languages from here, as well as managing your printers, other system settings. You can reset this if things are not working properly. You can do that right from here. And there's also some options to have this set up your phone and other devices conveniently by just taking a picture of the barcode even here. And then you've got the about, which is kind of nice. It tells you what version that you're on, which I couldn't find that on the old browser very easily. So it's kind of nice to know that you can go in there and see that here. Previously, we would go to help, and there was no about on the other one. There was only help. So here, if we go to about, it takes you right here exactly where we were looking, and it checks to make sure that it is up to date. So this is a great feature to tell you that the browser is on the latest version. So that's pretty much it for the new Microsoft Edge browser. You can go through this and play with the settings and personalization. And it's not a lot of differences, but there's a few things that make it a little bit better. And let me know what you think about this, if you've been using that, or are you still going to be sticking with Google Chrome or Firefox or some other web browser of choice. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thanks so much for sticking around. If you enjoyed this or found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And we will see you in future videos. All right, thanks so much. Bye for now.